Mitchell Trubisky has signed a 2-year deal with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Tom Downey, Mitchell Renz, breaking it all down for you here on NFL Daily by Chat Sports. We do not have the details as it stands right now. However, with this move happening, I believe now this is going to be Mitchell Trubisky's job, and you now have your new starting quarterback in the, I almost said silver and black, in the Pittsburgh Steelers colors. How about that?
Yeah, that's an interesting move. We knew that Trubisky had a lot of hype around him. Could he go to the Giants? Could he go to the Colts? Whatever. The Steelers had been linked to Trubisky, Jimmy Garoppolo, etc. I am very curious to see what the money looks like here. We are, of course, filming this live as the news breaks. So if we get the updates, we'll let you guys know. But the expectation here, Mitch, that he is the starter in Pittsburgh, at least for 1 year.
All right, so this was a tweet coming in from a guy who blocked me. The Steelers have reached an agreement on a 2-year deal with quarterback Mitchell Trubisky. Sources say the former number 2 overall pick heads to Pittsburgh as the expected starter in place of the retired Ben Roethlisberger. So Mitch Trubisky last season obviously didn't really get to play because they have a quarterback named Josh Allen who might be a little bit better, but he did have a 75% completion percentage. But what I look at here is this.
It was 8 attempts.
I do think, though, he looked good at times in the preseason. It's just a matter of which Mitch Trubisky are you going to get. He was actually a Pro Bowler at one time. He might have got in because some other people couldn't go in. But there's Mitch Trubisky with Matt Nagy and the Bears. Not good whatsoever. But there was definitely times last season with Brian Daboll when I was like, okay, I could understand it. I could wrap my mind around it. So here's what makes Chat Sports different, though. We keep you up to date on the news, the rumors, but I want you also to be interactive with us down in the comments section right now. Grade the move of Trubisky to Pittsburgh. A, B, C, D, or F. A, you absolutely love it. It's a slam dunk. B, it's a good move. C, it's an average move. D, it's bad. F, it's a big old fail. For me personally, I'm going to go ahead and give this a C move because I think it's a good move. You needed a quarterback. But until those figures come out, then it's kind of TBD. As long as it's under $15 million a year, I'll probably keep my answer at a C. If it goes above that, the grade's going to go lower. As simple as that. I just see it starting at $10 million.
I would expect something similar. I wonder what the cost is going to be and how much they've committed to him. And does this take Pittsburgh out of the quarterback market in the draft? A lot of buzz around them out of the Senior Bowl. They love Malik Willis, Kenny Pickett. Maybe they know they weren't going to get one of those guys. They were going to be off the board by the time they got up on the clock. So it is an anti-Mason Rudolph move. It's also interesting to me, Mitch, for Trubisky to go from everyone agreeing, oh yeah, he's bad, a year ago, to throwing 8 passes in Buffalo and going, well, it's time for him to start, you know, as a QB again. He's earned that opportunity. He didn't do anything.
I know.
So the hype around Trubisky is, in the end, I know this happens a lot, it's based around where you were drafted. Top 2 pick. He was always going to get another shot, regardless of how bad it was his last 2 years in Chicago, where it was pretty middling overall. It was maybe average. Is he a great backup? Absolutely. Is he a franchise QB? He turns 28 this year.
Yeah.
No, is the answer as far as I'm concerned.
I mean, not only on top of that, he just got married. He is expecting to have a kid, and I've never had those things, but I would imagine that's a lot to weigh on you. You're moving into a new city. You just got married. You're about to have a new kid. Like, I don't think at times people realize the off-the-field stuff, how much it impacts these players on the field, and that's a lot to take into consideration here. So what do y'all think here? Why for yes and for no? Will Mitch Trubisky start for the Pittsburgh Steelers? I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to type my Y for yes because I just think at this current moment, he is the best option to do that. And, you know, sure, maybe they go out, they draft a quarterback. You learn behind Trubisky for 2 years. That way you don't get thrown to the wolves in a tough division. I'm going to type my Y for yes. What do you think?
I think yes. I think there'll be a competition for Mason Rudolph, but he's getting paid like a backup QB anyway. So I would expect Trubisky is your year one starter for the Pittsburgh Steelers here.
I mean, has there ever been a quarterback that has been able to upgrade his value more by not playing ever?
I mean, this happens.
Does it?
Yeah.
But this much, though.
Like, Mariota wasn't playing and got $20 million on the open market.
Technically, he played. He just got benched.
He got benched. So, like, I think in the past, can I count Sam Darnold there? Last year, like, he sucked for the Jets and got all this input.
Josh Rosen.
All this money. Rosen, sure. Like, it happens with early round draft picks. Teams and organizations and fans are so attached to, well, he must be good because he was an early round pick, that they get way more benefit of the doubt than other teams and than other players do. If Trubisky was a fourth round pick, I guarantee you he does not get this contract.
No, and I agree with that. I mean, I feel like every NFL coach, every GM is like, they see like a shiny car and they're like, you know what? I can make that car drive. That car didn't have the right tools or right tires or right engine to make it go in its previous destination. Most of the time we find out that the car just doesn't run that well. Yeah. And I think Mitch Trubisky might be in that situation, especially if they don't put some pieces around him. They got to build that offensive line back up. You got a good running back, obviously, in Najee Harris. But Chase Claypool, Deonta Johnson, those are two good receivers.
Yeah.
However, you know, we'll see what happens with somebody like Juju Smith-Schuster. I also love Pat Freiermuth.
Yeah.
But, you know, then that kind of takes us, you know, to our next, you know, thing with the Pittsburgh Steelers and everything going on. When free agency started, they were at about $27 million. And some people might argue that team need could still be a quarterback. You might see them address it in
these,
the draft.
These teams' needs are based before free agency began. I still think it is a need. Maybe not your number one need. Corner is a big area of concern with Akello Witherspoon, a free agent. They did keep Arthur Mallett as one of their backups. Joe Hayden's a free agent. Offensive tackle, guard. You could go safety with Terrell Edmonds as a free agent. So they took care of at least a short-term QB option. I don't think he's their long-term fit. But for a team that still wants to win football games right now, I do think Trubisky's an upgrade over Mason Rudolph, who I just don't like that much.
You guys ever find yourself driving down the road? Maybe you're walking your dog. I don't know. Maybe you're sitting down, dropping a number two, and you're looking for a YouTube channel that talks about the Steelers. Well, we actually have this really cool Steelers-only YouTube channel called Steelers Talk, and we're trying to get to 9,000 subscribers on that bad boy. So if you could, go ahead, subscribe. It's youtube.com/SteelersTV. So whether you're a member of the Steel Curtain, whether you're just looking for news, rumors, everything breaking down around the Pittsburgh Steelers, this is the YouTube channel for you. So seriously, go ahead, check it out. And if you're one of our loyal watchers, take that link that you see below and send it to some Steelers friends. So the reason why we're breaking all these moves down here is because Mitchell Trubisky is the first quarterback that has been signed in NFL free agency. I didn't have him as the number one guy.
You had Winston, I assume?
I had Winston at number one, though I would say the most intriguing player at quarterback was Mitchell Trubisky. Because now that I think that this went down, you could see a few other things end up going down. Because Trubisky's off the board, but now I think this opens up the market for quarterback trades like Jimmy Garoppolo. Where does he end up going?
It takes Pittsburgh out of the race for Jimmy G.
Sure.
Leaves open teams like the Colts, for example, still in there. I will make note that Jeremy Fowler reports that Trubisky's decision came down to the Steelers and the New York Giants.
Ooh.
Was this a Buffalo leak to get a better comp pick to drive up the interest in Trubisky? We'll see what the contract numbers say there.